Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the inaugural edition of This Game Fucks, where I fanboy over a video game because of how super duper rad it is. To kick things off, we're looking at Yakuza Kiwami, the 2016 remake of the original game that came out 10 years prior. Also, 2016 was a slightly busy year for Ryoga Gotoku Studio, as they also released Yakuza 6 that year, although it was 11 months later, but damn, I hope they had multiple teams working on this stuff. Crunch ain't no joke, and should 100% be outlawed. Nevertheless, this game takes us back to the year 2006, a time where here in the States, bands like Seether and Shinedown were making an impact, TNA Impact was becoming the most must-watch wrestling show on Earth, and Kingdom Hearts 2 was melting everyone's minds and totally not leaving everyone hanging with a million portable games before the third real entry over 10 years later. Our tale centers around high-ranking Yakuza and all-around sweethearted good boy Kazuma Kiryu. How good? Like, take the fall for murdering the chairman of the entire family he belongs to so his best friend, Akira Nishiyama, can stay out of prison and tend to his dying sister good. Not only that, but during his time in prison, Kiryu gets expelled from the Dojima family, and not only that, but when he eventually gets out 10 years later, he learns that the boss that took the place of the one that was murdered was also murdered! And if that wasn't enough drama, good old Nishiki turned heel, becoming an absolute sociopath. And guess what? Kiwami adds cutscenes before the start of every chapter, we get to see every step of his downfall from good-natured Yakuza to bloodthirsty pretty boy. Oh, and his childhood sweetheart has gone missing. And she has a long-lost sister who is also missing. Oh, and her sister has a kid, Haruka Sawamura. Why do I mention this kid by name? Because she becomes one of the main characters of this entire franchise, and it's her father-daughter relationship with Kiryu that drives a lot of what happens in later games, especially 5 and 6. If you're ever feeling overwhelmed by all the plot twists, then don't worry, Yakuza has you covered with a metric fuckton of sub-stories and mini-games to play through. I really do enjoy a vast majority of the sub-stories here, as they establish Kiryu as a man of the people, and whenever you help people, it just makes you feel good inside. As for the mini-games, they're pretty goddamn good, although far from the best this series would have to offer. Then again, if the first game had all the best stuff, then that would be rather sad. Karaoke is always a fun time if you enjoy rhythm games, but try not to lose focus when everything goes into super rad music video mode! There's also bowling, which is, well, bowling. It's 100% unadulterated bowling. Yup. Then we have what you'll probably be seeking hours into, Pocket Circuit Racing, hosted by everyone's favorite NPC not named Majima, Pocket Circuit Fighter! Between finding customizable parts, helping PCF find his replacement so he can settle down with his fiance, and just seeing Kiryu have a few moments of legitimate happiness in this series full of bittersweetness, this is just the best. But of course, most of the time when you're roaming around the district of Kamurocho, you'll be engaging in random encounter battles and beating the absolute fuck of whomever makes the mistake of stepping up to the Dragon of Dojima. What keeps the combat from feeling old is that Yakuza Kiwami sports four different fighting styles to switch between: Brawler, which is your jack of all trades, Rush, which prioritizes speed over strength, Beach, which is the exact opposite of Rush, and Dragon, which starts off as your weakest but can become very overpowered by endgame. How is this? Well, your main rival of the game, Goto Majima, has what can only be described as a fetish for fighting Kiryu and wants him at his absolute best. How does he do this? By challenging him to a ton of fights, of course. Oh, and the odd game of bowling, which is bullshit because unless you're an expert, he will kick your ass. No, really, look at this score! I had to bowl a damn near perfect game just to barely win. Back on a positive note, the fights with Majima can happen literally anywhere. Sometimes he'll just see you walking down the street and run up to you, or he can surprise you as a member of quote-unquote law enforcement. Or he can seduce you into a fight via a pole dance. Truly, the sky is the limit in terms of what this beautiful bastard can think of. Speaking of limit, the city of Kamurocho, aka the setting of this game, as well as every sequel and prequel, is small, but the feeling of being in a big city is not lost due to the brilliant choice of how it was designed. In the lower half, you have a few streets leading south, and then in the middle, there's this gigantic Millennium Tower, to the west there's the Theater District, and more towards the northeast you can find a park full of homeless people that secretly houses a Colosseum. The point is, no matter where you go, you'll find something. This city was clearly built with a thought process of better to stuff all this stuff into one tiny location than to spread out over dozens of square miles.
And ladies and gentlemen, that is why this game sucks. Yeah! good one. I mean, just by this game, you can enjoy a fun beat 'em up overworld RPG, you know? It's just, you're gonna have a good time. You're going to have a good time. In fact, though, hold on. God, you can barely hear what I'm saying. Oh, my ear! God damn! Ah! I did not think about the logistics of this at all! Nevertheless, put that down there. If you want to start somewhere even earlier in the timeline, we do have Yakuza 0 right over yonder. And then, if you want to start even somewhere just completely different, just a game that has nothing to do with Yakuza, just with the same gameplay with just completely different characters, Mel Blamo, this is North Star, Lost Paradise. And then, once you have all of that, you got Yakuza Kiwami 2, which is actually over there. I don't have it over here because, well, while I do own the game physically, I don't actually own the original box art. Unfortunately, it didn't come with it. Kinda sucks. Anyways, once you have all that, you got the Yakuza Collection right here, 3 and 4, which also comes with 5, but they decided to give us the PS3 little box art right here because, well, we in the West, we didn't quite get this game, at least not physically, so they decided to throw us a bone with the whole Yakuza Collection with 3, 4, and 5 remastered. Just give us this physical disc, which is nice to have because now I actually have a PS3 case in my collection for once. And then, of course, over here, yeah, Yakuza 6! Finish the whole Cosmic Kiryu story! Just finish it off right there! Now we're all ready for Yakuza 7, or Yakuza, Yakuza Electric Dragon, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Well, I'm just flooding all over my lines, I'm just so full of energy, man. Ooh, I haven't recorded these videos in quite some time! Just shame this video's not gonna be out for another couple of weeks! But hey, at least you'll have my anniversary out. So at least there is that! And you know what? I'm going to put this energy, easy for me to say, towards something a lot more positive, extremely positive. And that is plugging my friend's book, New World by Greg Hay. It's available right now on Amazon.com, both physically and digitally. And while this book may seem big, it's only because the text is also kind of big, you know? There's a lot of things that go on behind the scenes when it comes to actually trying to publish a book that I was not aware of until my friend told me about it. So yeah, you kind of need to put, you know, have things formatted a certain way. Also, if you enjoy this art, this is done by one of my patrons, Casey N. Moore, aka the Evil Reverend. Look at this. This is amazing artwork. Look at this. So go on, check out his DeviantArt page. I'm gonna put both those links in the description down below. Actually, I don't think I can put the Amazon link down below because when my friend tried to do that for his YouTube video, those videos got taken down. So you know what? I'll put Casey's DeviantArt in the description down below so that way you can go check that out. Just look this up on Amazon, New World by Greg Haynes. It's really good stuff, trust me. I'm not an author, and I know jack all about books being good. So you can trust my opinion! Anyways, until next time, this is TWK of TWK Reviews, telling you to work your gimmick! Fuck the police!
ジマノリュウと直接やり合える本物の命張った喧嘩ができるなあゲルちゃんならわかるやろなあおぎふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふふ